Hi guys, how's everyone doing this lovely day? And welcome back to our channel. Thank you so much for stopping by, guys. If you are wondering why I am starting my video off with my Nikon B500, it's because I'm going to do a mini tutorial on how to use this wonderful camera that I got for vlogging. And I got from a request from a new subscriber as to how to use this so that he can start vlogging. It's finally here, guys. So this is my Nikon B500 that I got from Best Buy at about roughly $300. Right now, I think it's a little less, but I'm just going to give you the basics. First, we're gonna start off with the basics. It's a camera for shooting videos and also taking amazing pictures. The lens goes up to 40x wide optical zoom EDVR. Now, here is a cool feature. So first, when I first got this camera, I thought that this flipped all the way towards my face so that I can see myself, but this is actually for hard to reach spots when you are recording or when you're taking pictures. So basically, if you're taking a picture from a really difficult angle, you can aim it all the way up and you can see on the screen where you're aiming, or you can aim all the way down and you can see here. So when you flip it this way, so this is what this feature is for. Also has the feature for the flash. So this is where the flash is right here, and you just click this button and the flash pops out. And it also has the zoom, 40x zoom here. Okay, Wi-Fi, built-in Wi-Fi. So you can also, it also has the Bluetooth feature. As you can see here, it has the Bluetooth feature and the Wi-Fi feature. You can connect your phone, you can connect your tablet, your laptop with it, and you can also connect any other device that you have via Bluetooth. Now, onto the features to take a picture. So let's turn it on so you can see, guys. All right. So here is set for video, as you can see. Come here, princess. Let's set you up for a video. All right, so down here is the timing that you have left. So if you want to take a video, I always suggest that you leave it on green, on this green button here, which is the generic camera mode. Because when you leave it here, then it actually it adapts to the environment. This one here, it adapts to the environment, and it adapts to whether it's night mode or day mode. It'll adapt to it, and it gives you the most time. So this one here usually gives you 29 minutes, but because I have a lot of videos inside and there's not enough space, so it's only giving me 19 minutes. Before I get on to this, I want to get on with the onto the basic features here. So this is the display button. Let's turn it back on. So it'll go into sleep mode, inactive mode. If you don't move it, it'll go into inactive mode like it's doing right now. So just click back on it and it'll turn back on. Now, this is the display button. This here, it'll show you all the features that it has right now that be used. So you don't have the flash on, so that's anti-flash. And this is the battery. But here I wanted to, about the battery, before we move on, this camera requires 4 AA batteries, and because it requires 4 AA batteries, I highly suggest that you get yourself, this is a rechargeable battery unit, and it recharges your batteries. It comes with 4 Energizer batteries, AA batteries, and so this, because this camera requires 4 AA batteries, but it also has the option to purchase the extension to charge it. So, but you can get it on Amazon, and I'll put the link down below as to where you can get it. So it's the AV out, this one here, and this is where, so you purchase the extension to charge it. You can do that. But I've left it on batteries because I have the rechargeable battery unit, and that's why I've left it like it is. I just charge my batteries overnight and they'll last pretty long. They'll actually, these batteries will last about a week. So I don't really need to charge them for too long. This is the handle here with a nice thick grip, comfortable grip for your right hand. It also comes with a strap that I do not have anymore. I no longer have, but the strap connects here and it connects here, and you can hang it on around your neck. It also comes with a built-in microphone. So I'm sorry, these are the speakers and this is the microphone. So it has a pretty really good microphone. I mean, I know other cameras you can connect a microphone to it, but this one you cannot connect a microphone to it, but it comes with a really good microphone, and I mean the sound is very good. This right here is for the tripod, and any tripod fits. This is very universal, it fits, and I'll show you right now. This is the tripod that I got at Best Buy. I also have other tripods. I have this tripod for my LED lights, and I also have another tripod right over there. This tripod over here, it does fit my camera, but it's a little thinner. This tripod is perfect. I don't know why the other tripods don't really fit. It's just kind of like, so princess. The tripod that I bought with the camera, it doesn't come with it. This is a universal tripod, but I love this tripod because it can get longer depending on where you want to stand it. But, you know, we're not talking about the tripod today. We're talking about the camera today. But I highly recommend you get a tripod for your camera so that you can set it wherever you want to set it. I usually use this large tripod, but this tripod is for smaller spaces, or, you know, when you want to set it on a table. So I think it's perfect for that. All right, now let's get on with the technical stuff here. Right, and then you frame the picture. So move the zoom control or the side zoom control to change the zoom lens position if you lose sight of the subject. While shooting with the lens in telephoto position, press the snap back button to temporarily widen the visible area so that you can frame the subject more easily. Press the shutter release button halfway. To press the shutter release button halfway means to press and hold the button at the point where you feel a slight resistance. When the subject is in focus, the focus area or focus indicator is displayed in green. So when the subject becomes in focus, you'll see a little square around their face, and that's when it's gonna start focusing the face. When you're using digital zoom, the camera focuses in the center of the frame and the focus area is not displayed. If the focus area or focus indicator flashes, the camera is unable to focus. Modify the composition and try pressing the shutter release button halfway again. So you're gonna press this button halfway to focus, and that's usually what I do to focus, and it usually works the first time around. To record movies, display the shooting screen and press the record button, movie record. So here we have the record button, and this is where I record my videos. Here I press this button and I start recording, and I usually leave it on this green camera mode. You can play with it, guys, to see what each function does. This one here, the little man swimming right here, is sports. I would highly suggest pressing this one, changing it to this one when it's a video that's highly in motion, when you're constantly on the run or moving, so it can autofocus. Because sports, obviously, there's gonna be a lot of movement, so this is perfect for autofocus. And I always recommend that one. So for vlogging, guys, I just highly suggest you turn the on button. Just turn the on button. Leave it on the green camera for vlogging. This green one. And you press record, guys. That's all you do. You press record. Now let's press record so you guys can see. Let's record my sofa. Do you see the numbers? The letter, the seconds are counting down. Let's record my cat, Princess. It's recording, guys. It's on the generic green camera mode. And as you see, it autofocuses. Right? Let's turn it off. Okay, so then what you're gonna do to play it back, you're gonna press the playback button, which is this square with a triangle in the middle, playback button. And you're gonna see the video that we just recorded, and it's only 25 seconds. And it tells you how many minutes you have left. You press okay to play it back. So you guys see that is the view, that is the display, and that's the image that you're going to get with the green button. Now let's try sports. You see that, guys? Okay, so let's press the record button. Here, this little button right here. This is a short movie mode, this one. So when we change it to short movie mode, it plays up to 30 seconds of short movie clips, and it'll automatically put them all together. So if you want to do something like that, then you can do it. If your vlogs are really short, or if your videos are really short, if you want to try that, you can go ahead and do it. I never use this because I vlog for longer than 15 minutes at most times. And so it just doesn't make sense for me to use this because it'll stop every 30 seconds. It'll stop and then play again. Stop. Play again, stop, play again, stop, play again. And it's just not, it's really obnoxious and annoying for me, so I wouldn't recommend that. So this is just a basic tutorial on how to vlog. Now, once you stop your video, like let's turn it on. And let's say we're gonna record. This is in the movie recording process. See, it has 7 out of 15 clips. Okay. Once you're finished recording, you hit the red button again and it stops, okay? So you can double check on these minutes. If it stopped counting down, then the video has stopped. So you play back, you hit okay to play back, and there it is. Sissy, basically what you want to have is a crisp, clear picture of what you're recording, and make sure you have great lighting. You can use natural lighting, which is the lighting outside, which is what I'm using right now. This is the natural lighting, guys. You want to face, you want to stand, like your back wants to stand against the light, so that way you have the lighting facing the camera. Or you can use professional lighting, which is this right here. These are my ring lights that I got from Amazon. I can put the link down below for these lights if you are interested. And I'll also put the link down below for where to purchase this camera and where to purchase the tripod. You want to have a tripod, dude. You want to have a tripod because it's going to help you steady your shaking. It's going to steady the shaking from your hand. And that's it, guys. That's it. This is a basic tutorial on how to vlog. If you want an in-depth tutorial on how to use this camera for shooting pictures and all sorts of other things, and let me know down below and I'll do an in-depth tutorial for this camera. But this is just basically for vlogging, because I use this only for vlogging, and these are the buttons that I use and the modes that I use to vlog. So set it in the green camera. You press, this is in sleep mode right now. If it's okay, if it's flashing, it's in sleep mode. It's gonna stop flashing and it's gonna turn off. Here's another thing before I hang up, before I end this video. Let's turn it back on. I'm gonna show you how to focus on something if it's really far away. So you hold your camera, right? This is the close up here, getting close, and this is further, okay? So let's go back to the record mode. Let's go do a close-up. That's Audrey Hepburn. You see how it focuses? All right, there we go. There's a 40x zoom. Okay, and then you press record to record. It's gonna defocus if you're not steady, guys. Go. All right, so now it's focused. This is it. See, it's trying to focus on a, like, you see the yellow outline? It's trying to, it thinks it's trying to focus on the door, but I'm actually trying to focus on Audrey's face. And there we go. Let's go 40x zoom. See, so once it goes 40x zoom, this, of course, gets longer and longer until you reach the maximum limit. And this is amazing for pictures. And it also, okay, so you want to do, when you want to focus, you just click halfway and it'll focus. All right, it's trying to focus. You see that red light? All right, guys, and that's the regular zoom. And that's it. Guys, if you like this tutorial, give it a huge thumbs up to support our channel, guys. And also, hit the subscribe button if you are interested in more tutorials like these. And also hit the bell to be notified for more tutorials, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for watching my Cool Pics B500 basic tutorial on how to vlog. If you have any questions, please comment below, and I will answer all of your questions, guys. And I will do an in-depth tutorial if you are interested in an in-depth tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.